Hello and welcome to this video tutorial where I show you how to lock and hide apps on your iPhone. So basically, there is a new feature in iOS 18, which is the first thing you have to do is you need to make sure you have updated and are running the most recent version of the operating system or iOS on your iPhone. And then once you've done that, go ahead and go to the app that you want to require Face ID and lock. So let's just say it's Snapchat. You'll need to haptic press or tap and hold on your device to pull up these options. Then you're going to see an option that says require Face ID. If we tap into require Face ID, it says this app will require Face ID or your passcode to open or show contents in other apps. App content will not appear in notification previews or spotlight. So even people searching your phone or notifications that will randomly pop up, this app will basically be in stealth mode is what I like to call it. So you can have two options. You can just require Face ID. So if we tap on require Face ID, so now when I try to open up the app, I tap the app and it will require Face ID and it checks it out. And then I can go ahead and open up that app. And then once here, go ahead and go to require Face ID. And then you can see here it says hide and require Face ID. Require Face ID. It'll go ahead and check our Face ID first. And now the app is no longer searchable or found here on the home screen anywhere. But if I go over to my list of apps, you'll now see a folder that says hidden. And in order to open the hidden folder, I tap into the hidden folder here and I either have to do Face ID or type in my passcode. Then it will show the apps in the hidden folder. I can tap into the hidden folder, go ahead and tap into the app, go to Face ID, and you're good to go. Also under settings, you'll see some new hidden apps settings under that as well. But basically all you're wanting to do is tap on the specific app and then you can go to require Face ID and set up your settings for that specific app that way. So again, adding a lot more deepened privacy on the iPhone. If you have any further questions, put those down below. If this helped you, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in the next video.